Yes, I have tricks in my pocket. I have things up my sleeve, but I am the opposite of a stage magician. They give you illusion that has the appearance of truth. I give you truth in the pleasant disguise of illusion. To begin, I turn back time. I reverse it to that quaint period, the Golden Age. You see, the Philippines was under US occupation during that time. Their small town provincial hopes brightened by the sight of purple mountains' majesty. A surge of Filipinos immigrated to America in search of prosperity, seeking that American dream. They set sail to the promised land to till and to toil the earth, harvesting America's crops while leaving their loved ones behind. Little did they know, these young Filipino immigrants would serve as a source of cheap labor. This is the social background of the play. The play, or dance, or whatever this is memory. Being a memory play is dimly lighted. It is sentimental. It is not realistic. In memory, everything seems to happen in music. Well, that explains the cha-cha song playing in the background. I am the narrator of the dance, and also a character in it. The other characters are sitting behind me on the bench upstage. They represent the oppressed and the oppressors, the obedient and the defiant. Throughout the work, you might see them embodying strength and resistance. You may see them having fun or recalling an old memory from their ancestors' past. But since I have a poet's weakness for symbols, I am using these characters also as a symbol. They are the long-delayed but always expected something that we live for. There is another character in the dance who doesn't appear on stage at all. And that's you. Yes, you. The audience. You see, my dad, he loved bringing people together. Well, he's the reason we're all here today in this theater. He was born in 1912 on a remote island in central Philippines called Cabilao. 5 square miles of lush jungle and coral landscapes. He immigrated to America in 1932 during the Great Depression. Promised the opportunity for prosperity, he and his friends joined a group of starry-eyed Filipinos on a voyage across the Pacific for over 30 days. A few people died on that journey and were tossed overboard. Which brings me back to you. Yes, you, the audience. You're the last character in this dance. You see, these memories and traumas that we are embodying are not images of reality. They're representations. You. And you. Your role within this work is to see these images and symbols and relate them to your own personal experiences. Other American experiences, or immigrant experiences, or the voice of indigenous people.